Good afternoon, everyone. Today, we are going to discuss the topic implantation, parturition, and lactation. Clear? But before that, as you know, we have discussed the topic fertilization, right? Fertilization basically means the fusion of a sperm with an ovum. Clear? Fertilization is fusion of sperm and ovum, right? What happens basically, suppose if I'm drawing the female reproductive system, let me draw the female reproductive system. So like this, uterus is there, at the end cervix is there, this is vagina, uterus, and then there is fallopian tube, right? This we have discussed in detail. And here ovaries are there. Ovary. One ovary is here and second one is on that side, right? So now like this. This we have done. Now, what happens in the process of fertilization? As you know, by the process of copulation, there will be insemination. In the vagina, penis will enter and it will ejaculate the sperm here. Now the sperm will move in the uterus. Okay. Now due to acidic environment of the vagina, the sperms, many sperms, they will get die. Only 200 to 300 they will be raised here. Okay. No doubt, 200 to 300 million sperms here in the vagina, 200 to 300 million sperms have been ejaculated by the penis. But here in the uterus, only 200 to 300 will be able to reach. Why? Because most of them, they will get died due to the acidic environment of the vagina. Now, these sperms will reach here. Now, what will happen in the uterus? There will be capacitation reaction. Now what is that? Let us talk about it. If I talk about the structure of the sperm, you know that there is head, then there is a neck, then there is middle piece, and then there is tail. This we have done, right? And the whole body of the sperm, it is covered with the help of the plasma membrane. So this is the plasma membrane. Clear? This is the plasma membrane. So what happens in the uterus? 200 to 300 million sperms they have reached here. Now, here there will be process of capacitation. In that process, the plasma membrane of the sperm, it will get weakened. Obviously, just use your common sense. If the plasma membrane will get weakened, only then it can break later on. And only that the inside material that is present in the nucleus, it can come out. Because ultimately, this nucleus has to fuse with the nucleus of the ovum. So now, the sperms they have raised here, they have undergone the process of capacitation. Now, as you know, ovary will release the secondary oocyte. That is not ovum. There is a difference between these two. Okay. So here, ovaries are going to release the secondary oocyte. In one cycle, in one menstrual cycle, one egg is released. Okay, so on an average, I can say in 28 to 29 days, only one secondary oocyte is released. So here the secondary oocyte is there. It will travel here. This part is infundibulum. This is fallopian tube. But this part is isthmus. This broadened part is ampulla, and this part that contains finger-like processes, this part is infundibulum. Now the secondary oocyte, it will travel and it will reach here at the junction of the isthmus and the ampulla. Now here the secondary oocyte is present. Fine. Now what will happen? The sperm will come. Sperms, they don't know whether they have to go to the right or the left. half of the sperm will go to right and half will go to the left. Clear? Wherever the ovum will be present, they will try to fertilize it. The rest sperms, they will get tied. Now, the sperms, they will reach here. No doubt, many sperms are reaching here, but only one will be able to fertilize. Now, suppose the sperms, they have reached here. So, here I am just drawing. Here, secondary oocyte is there. Okay. If I talk about the structure of the secondary oocyte, then outside it is covered by a layer that is known as zona pellucida. So here a layer is there that is known as zona pellucida. And outside the zona pellucida there are the cells of corona radiata. Clear? So basically this is the structure that is present here. So this is corona radiata. So the ovary is, the ovary releases the secondary oocyte one in one menstrual cycle. Clear? If I talk about the structure of that secondary oocyte, then this is that. Inside the secondary oocyte is there, which is covered by a layer of zona pellucida, which is further covered by the corona radiata. Clear? So now here this ovum is there, secondary oocyte basically, this which is covered by the zona pellucida and which is again covered by the corona radiata. Okay, now the sperm will come. Now they have to fertilize this. If you do remember the structure of the sperm, we have discussed one part, that is acrosome. Okay, suppose this is the structure, head, neck, middle piece and tail. In the head region, two things are present. One is acrosome here at the tip and then there is nucleus. Obviously, the nuclear material has to come out. Only then fertilization is going to take place. So what happens now? This acrosome, it contains hydrolytic enzymes. This acrosome, it contains hydrolytic enzymes. Because obviously, outside the secondary oocyte, zona pellucida is there, corona radiata is there. How the sperm is going to enter? With the help of this acrosome. This acrosome will burst, resultant the nucleus will come out. And the enzymes, they will help in the breakage of these layers, so that the sperm can get an entry. So now what will happen? The corona radiata will get broken down. Zona pellucida is there, no doubt. But the sperm, they will make a hole and they will be able to go inside like this. So the nucleus of the sperm, it has entered into the ovum. Now let me make it once again. Secondary oocyte was there. Secondary oocyte was there. Corona radiata has been broken down. Outside zona pellucida is there. Now the nucleus of the sperm, it has entered here. Okay. And inside one nucleus was there, that was of secondary oocyte. Now the second meiosis takes place. In the nucleus of the secondary oocyte, there will be meiosis 2. It will get divided into ovum and polar body. The polar body, it will get degenerate. Now we are having the ovum and now I'll write the ovum. Is it fine? So ovum is formed before fertilization. The fertilization hasn't taken place, but after the entry of the sperm. Clear? Now this is the nucleus of the ovum. This is the nucleus of the sperm. They will get fertilized. And now it is not ovum anymore. It will become a single nucleus, that is a single cell, that is zygote. So now zygote is there, which is surrounded by the zona pellucida. Clear? Zygote is there. Outside the zygote, obviously there is a plasma membrane. And outside that membrane, there is zona pellucida. Is it fine? Now, after fertilization, the zygote has been formed here. So now let me erase everything and let us talk about the implantation. What will happen after the process of fertilization? Let us talk about implantation. Clear? Let me erase this now. I'll draw it once again. So, I'm drawing the diagram of female reproductive system once again. Uterus is there. Then cervix. Vagina. Fallopian tube. Clear? Ovary. Same here. Now, just here, this zygote has been formed. And this zygote is surrounded by the zona pellucida. Now, what will happen if I talk about the uterus? You know that three linings are there. The outer one is perimetrium. The middle lining of the uterus is known as myometrium. This is myometrium. And the innermost lining of the uterus is known as endometrium. So here I am having endometrium. This endometrium is quite thick because it is having the blood vessels. Okay. So this is endometrium. Now the fertilization has taken place. Now what will happen, the zygote, it will start moving towards the uterus. And when it is moving, just imagine one thing, this zygote is a single cell. From this zygote we are supposed to be made. And we are having millions of cells. So obviously in this zygote there must be mitotic divisions. So what will happen when the zygote is moving towards the uterus? In the midway, the mitotic divisions are going on. Here one cell was there. Now one cell divides into two. This special type of mitosis is known as cleavage. Okay, here no doubt it is mitosis, but there is a special name for this, that is cleavage. Okay, so zona pellucida is there. Inside what will happen, from the one zygote cell, two will be made. Are you getting? Let me make it clear. Suppose there was zona pellucida and inside the zygote was there. Now what will happen? The zygote will divide into two. Zona pellucida is like this only. So the size of the cells, they are getting smaller. Now again the next division will take place. Now two cells, they result in the formation of four cells. Zona pellucida is there. It results in the formation of four cells. Okay. Now again there will be mitotic division. From the four cells, eight cells will be produced. Clear? Zona pellucida is there. Now 8 cells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now again there will be division. 16 cells. So, here, these cells. Here 2 cells are there. These cells are known as blastomere. After the cleavage, the number of the cells, it is increasing. We have given the term blastomere to the cells. Here 4 cells are there, so I can say 4 blastomeres are there. 8 cells are there, so we can say 8 blastomeres are there. Is it fine? Now this stage is known as morula. This stage or the next one, morula is having 8 to 16 blastomere. Here as I have drawn 8 blastomere, if I would have drawn 16 or in between 8 to 16, then that stage is known as morula. Like in this way the division, or I can say the better word, cleavage will keep on going. Okay, outside zona pellucida is there. Inside the zona pellucida zygote is there, that is having a single cell. One cell divides into two, or I can say one cell cleaves into two. 2 into 4, 4 into 8, then 16, and this stage is morula. Now this will keep on going from 16 to 32 and like this, 32 to 64, Finally, a stage will be formed that is known as blastocyst. Now, this was morula. Now, what happens in blastocyst? Obviously, the cells are dividing. Now, so many cells they have been produced. Now, there is a special arrangement of cell. How? Let us study. Zona pellucida is there. Now, there will be one layer of cell that is known as trophoblast. Here, trophoblast. This is the characteristic feature of the blastocyst that I am telling now. So, this is the trophoblast. Okay, there will be one layer of cell that is known as the trophoblast. And inside the trophoblast, there will be inner cell mass, means there will be a group of cells here. At one end, there will be a group of cell that is known as inner cell mass. This group. This is known as inner cell mass. Now, if you will see, in between the trophoblast and in between the inner cell mass here, there is a space. There is a cavity. This cavity is known as blastocoele. Clear? This cavity is known as blastocoele. So, now this is what is happening. This zygote has been formed here. It will keep on moving. Finally, it has to embed in the uterus. You know that in the uterus, the implantation will take place. Now, it will keep on moving like this. Okay. Here. Now, seventh day. It will implant here at this stage. Is it fine? When it is moving, it is undergoing these changes. One cell divides into 2 into 4 blastomere, then 8 blastomere, then 16 blastomere, then 32, and then finally a stage will come that is known as blastocyst. Now that blastocyst will get an implant here. Now just how? Let us see. Firstly, the blastocyst, it will make a cavity here. Like I have made a cavity, a space. Now, what will happen? Just see. After making the cavity, this blastocyst will get fixed here inside. And this inner cell mass will be towards inside. Clear? Like this. Trophoblast is there. Then inner cell mass is there. Inner cell mass will be pointed inwards. Okay. This inner cell mass, it is going to make the future embryo. Clear? And the layer of the trophoblast, it is going to make the placenta in the future. Clear? Now, here the linings are there. Now, what will happen? The uterine lining, they will cover this trophoblast. They will cover this blastocyst entirely like this. This layer of the uterus, it will cover the blastocyst entirely like this. Can you see? This is known as implantation. Means the blastocyst, it will get implanted in the uterine cavity, and for the rest 9 months, it will get developed here only. Clear? Now, let us talk about the next step. Gestation, or I can say the development of the fetus. Now, obviously you know that in human being the gestation period is of 9 months. So for 9 months, this blastocyst will be here only, and it will result in the formation of a fetus. How? Let us talk about. Firstly, if I talk about this stage, trophoblast is there, right? And inside that, there is inner cell mass. I told you this inner cell mass is going to make the future embryo. And the trophoblast is going to make the placenta, and here is the blastocoele. Okay, this structure is present here. Now, what will happen with the help of the trophoblast? this trophoblast and the uterine tissue, both trophoblast as well as the uterine tissue, they will make finger like projections. The trophoblast will also make the finger like projections and the uterus also. So what will happen, these finger like projections, they get interdigited like this. These are the digits of your hands. They will get interdigited, means one finger like projections are being made by the trophoblast of the growing embryo. Second is being made by the uterus, means both are equally involved, the growing baby as well as the mother. This get interdigited and it results in the formation of placenta. So here there results in the formation of placenta. Placenta, as you know, it is a kind of connection. Okay, placenta is the connection between the mother and the embryo. Through the placenta only, the food, nutrients will be supplied to the growing embryo by the mother. Plus, the growing embryo is now going to make CO2, nitrogenous waste, that is going to be removed through this placenta only. Clear? Now, what will happen? There is second structure, umbilical cord. You might be knowing, after the birth of the child, the doctors used to cut this umbilical cord also. Umbilical cord is that cord with the help of which the placenta is attached with the embryo. Now just think, the placenta has been formed here, right? Now, from the inner cell mass, the embryo is going to be made. Let me make the embryo, suppose. From the inner cell mass, there will be growth of the embryo. Suppose here is the embryo. Growing fetus. Now, there is an umbilical cord that connects the placenta with the fetus or with the growing embryo. Embryo is going to be formed by the inner cell mass. Is that fine? So, umbilical cord, placenta, they help in the exchange of the things. With the help of these only, the mother is going to give the nutrients and food to the growing embryo, and the waste CO2 of the embryo is going to be removed. Clear? Now, next thing. Placenta. It acts as an endocrine gland. Means it is going to release some hormones. Clear? Now we have to study about the different hormones that are released by the placenta. So placenta secretes HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin hormone. Clear? Second hormone that is released by the placenta is HPL, human placental lactogen. Next, estrogen, progesterone. These are the four hormones that are released by the placenta. HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin hormone, HPL, human placental lactogen hormone, estrogen and progesterone. Clear? Now, after the 9 months, or I can say when the delivery is supposed to be there, at that time, ovary, they release one hormone that is known as relaxin. Okay, during the time of parturition, the ovary used to release a hormone that is relaxin. So basically, there are three hormones that are present only in the pregnant women. They are not present in the women who is not pregnant. These three hormones, HCG, HPL, relaxin. Amongst these three, HCG and HPL, these are secreted by the placenta, and relaxin is secreted by the ovary. These three hormones are there that are released only and only during the pregnancy. Clear? Now, the embryo is there. Now, what will happen? This embryo, this growing embryo, the inner cell mass, it is developing into the embryo. So, first of all, three layers will be formed. As you know, we are triploblastic, ectoderm, endoderm will also be produced, and in between these two there will be mesoderm. So what will happen? Trophoblast is there, it has made the placenta. Now leave that. Okay, now inside the inner cell mass is there, that is going to make the embryo that I told you. Okay, so now the inner cell mass, it get differentiated into ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, which is present in between these three, in between these two. These layers are having stem cells. Stem cells means they can give rise to each and every tissue, each and every organ of the body. So from these three layers, from the inner cell mass, these three layers, that is ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, these has been differentiated. Now these three layers, they are able to make each and every part. From these three layers, each and every part of the fetus is going to be made in the next 9 months. Am I clear? The stage that has implanted here was blastocyst. The blastocyst was having trophoblast and inner cell mass. Trophoblast plays an important role in the formation of the placenta. Now inner cell mass, it get differentiated into ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. Now these three layers, they are going to make each and every part of the growing fetus. Now by the first week of the pregnancy, the heart of the growing individual used to get formed. Okay, by first week, sorry, that is first month. By first month of the pregnancy, okay, the heart of the fetus, it used to get formed and it can easily analyze with the help of a stethoscope. Okay, the heartbeat of the growing fetus can be easily heard by the doctors using a stethoscope. Now by the second month, okay, by the second month, the fetus used to develop the digits like this. Okay, and limbs. So digits used to get developed. By the third month is first trimester. You know the gestation period is of 9 months. Okay, third month, first trimester, then next 3 months means 6 months, second trimester, and then finally parturition. Now that what I told you, 3 months, it is first trimester. Next 3 months, or it will become 6. Second trimester will be there. And then finally after 9 months, there will be parturition. So first month, the heart is formed. Second month, there is formation of digits, limbs. And third month, almost each and every organ of the fetus has been made. Okay, by the first trimester, almost each and every system has been made. Now, after that, in the fifth month, we can observe the movement of the limbs. Okay, the growing fetus used to start kicking, or I can say the movement of the limbs can be easily studied here at this stage. Clear? And then for the coming 9 months, the fetus is going to develop fully. And after that, what will happen after the completion of the gestation period, or after the completion of the 9 months, there will be the next step, that is parturition. Now what happens in parturition, let us study. Parturition means the expelling out of the fetus. Suppose here the fetus has been there for the 9 months. Now it has been fully developed. All the organ system, they have been developed. Now what will happen? The uterus, the lining of the uterus, it will undergo contraction. Just imagine, it is undergoing contraction. Now what will happen? The fetus, it is expelled out. Due to the uterine contraction of the uterus, the fetus is expelled out through the birth canal. This is cervical canal, this is vagina. Cervical canal and vagina, these two together form the birth canal. So what is parturition? The expelling of the fully grown fetus through the birth canal. Now, how does this happen? Just let us study. After the completion of the 9 months, the fetus has been fully developed. Now, what will happen? This fetus plus the uterus, this fetus that has been fully developed plus the uterus, the lining of the uterus, they will start mild contraction. Only mild contraction will be there. Plus, as I told you about the relaxin, at this time, when the 9 months of the gestation period has been completed, the ovary will secrete a hormone known as relaxin. That relaxin hormone will also do the same function. Now the uterus lining will start contracting, but slowly. So now the contractions, they have been started. Okay. The fetus and the uterus, the fully grown fetus is giving the signs itself that I am ready to be ejaculated out. So the fetus itself is giving the signals. Okay. The uterine cavity is itself giving the signals. They both are making the uterus to contract. This is fetal ejection. Okay. Fetal ejection reflex. Now what will happen due to these? The uterus is going to be contracted. Now due to these contractions, due to these mild contractions, now the contractions, they are only mild. They are not enough to eject the baby. The mild contractions, what will they do? They are having a reflex action on the pituitary. Due to these mild contractions, the posterior pituitary, it will release a hormone that is oxytocin. Oxytocin is birth hormone. Due to the mild contraction of the uterus, the posterior pituitary will secrete a hormone that is oxytocin. Now that oxytocin will come. Now that oxytocin, it will induce severe contractions. Now due to this oxytocin, the uterine contractions, they will become high. Okay, as a result, what will happen? The contractions are becoming higher. Again, the reflex action will be there. A message will be sent to the posterior pituitary. More oxytocin will get released. There will be more contraction. More contraction means more oxytocin, then more contraction, then more oxytocin, then more contraction. Finally, what will happen due to these strong contractions? Now the fully grown baby will be ejected out through the birth canal. That is parturition. Is it fine? Now during this time also, one thing is also going on, that is lactation. As you know that the fully growing fetus, it used to get fed by the mother. The fetus will feed on the milk of the mother, right? So what happens actually during the pregnancy or during the late stage of the pregnancy, when the parturition time is about to come, at that time the breast of the mother, it will get developed, it will get differentiated. The glands which are present in the breast, they will get developed, it will get filled with the milk, clear? So that after the birth of the child can feed on this milk, as this milk, basically colostrum, the initial milk that is being fed by the mother to the baby is colostrum. Okay, after the parturition, in the initial days, that milk which is fed by the mother to the growing feet, to the baby, that is colostrum, and it is highly rich in antibodies, IgA antibodies. That's why it is said that the milk of the mother, it is highly nutritious, as it is going to provide the antibodies to the child so that he or she can fight with the diseases. Am I clear? Thank you.